কারণ প্রবলেম ডোমেন্স মানে তার ইনপুট ইমেজ নো।
Yes, problem domain means when I suppose the user has a specific problem regarding a specific field, and in this case we are talking on image. Huh? So image মানে তোমার problem domain মানে তেনেকুৱা আৰু কিছুমান problem face কৰিব পাৰা ন, like you can face some problem at any point. So that's why we have the knowledge base. Okay, so knowledge base means it consists of all the domains in that base, and one domain is the problem domain. So today also you will get the same thing. So today we'll explain on elements of digital image processing. Okay. So we'll start with problem domain only. So here you can see a figure, right? So in this figure you can see certain elements of digital image processing. Okay, so those are totally different from yesterday's topics. Okay, so here you can see we have a problem domain, then sensors, software, storage, displays, hard copy, hardware and computer, and finally this is allocated to a network. So you're asking me what is a problem domain, right? So problem domain means a problem a user they face at any step in the image processing. Okay, that is, here we are talking about an image. So it is saying that a problem a user faces on a specific field. So here field means we'll be talking about all these elements. Okay, so then after we get to know about the problem, we'll start with the image sensors. Okay, so image sensors means what? So what do you understand by sensors now? Sensors means some signals, right?
Yes.
So signals in case of image, what do you mean?
Wavelets.
Yes, wavelets. Wavelets means what? Yesterday we spoke on wavelets as well. So see, these all are connected. That's why I'm asking. If you have any doubt, just relate. Okay. So what is a wavelet? Wavelet ki asle?
It is a scale. The scale of the image used to measure numerical form.
Acha. Good. Correct. Also keep a copy along with you. Okay. So if you have any doubt, or if I use some particular terms, you can jot it down. Okay. So wavelets, you know. So image sensors, it means some form of signals. Okay, and when we are referring to image sensing now, again we have two elements. Okay, here we will acquire two elements. That is, one will be a physical device and the other will be a digitizer. Okay, digitizer, digitizer, digitizer. So one is a physical, so two elements, one is a physical device and the other is a digitizer. So what will the physical device do? It is sensitive to some energy which will be radiated by some object present in the image. Okay, an object, you know now, object means a particular area in the image. Okay, so what the physical device will do, it will try to capture that image, that is, it will try to capture the energy which is radiated by the object in that image. Okay, you will understand this, right? And secondly is the digitizer. So what is a digitizer? Digitizer in layman terms, what do you understand? It means it is digitizing something, and digitize means it is in the digital form. Yes. So what a digitizer will do here, that it will convert the output which it has got from the physical device into some digital form. So did you get the connection here? That is, first is physical device. The physical device will capture the radiation from the image. And secondly is the digitizer. Digitizer will convert the output which it has got from the physical device into some digital form. And digital form here, I'm talking, suppose, okay, take an example of a physical device. Suppose we are talking about our camcorders, that is the physical, that is the digital video camera, say. So what happens there? There the sensors that are present there will produce an electrical output which is proportional to the light intensity in that image. Yes, that is, in simple terms, the camera is capturing the, suppose you want to take a video. So what is it doing? It is capturing the video, it is converting it into some, it is processing it, and then it is giving you the output, right? And suppose here what happens, the digitizer will convert those outputs to some digital data, and here digital data means digital image. Okay, so did you get the connection here now? Did you understand what is the first type, what is the second type?
Yes,
ma'am. Yes, yes. Okay, so then after you got this point, image sensors, then we go on to the specialized image processing hardware. So here what we have is specialized image hardware. What is a hardware? In general terms, what is a hardware and what is a software? Okay, and okay, whoever knows, tell me one by one. Okay, what is hardware?
And hardware are external devices.
Okay, and
software are the internal programs.
Why do we use? See, you all know these terms, but still I'm asking.
And software are to give the inputs and outputs to the system. And softwares process the inputs and create and give the results to display.
Okay. Yes, correct. Anyone else wants to say? So hardware, generally you are saying it is a physical device, right?
Yes, ma'am.
And software is already embedded in the system, right? Okay, so you know the difference. So here we are talking about the image hardware. So what an image processing hardware will do, it already consists of the two types which is already included in the image sensor, that is the physical device and the digitizer. Okay, so what it will do, the hardware which contains the digitizer will perform some specific operations. Okay, so this hardware will perform some specific operations on the image. And suppose let's take arithmetic logic unit. Okay, one type of operation is performed by the arithmetic logic unit. So what is arithmetic logic unit? Simply, it performs arithmetical and logical operations, but here we are talking about the image. So arithmetic logic unit, it won't be able to perform directly on the image. So for that we use the specialized image processing hardware. Okay, you can also name this hardware as from end subsystem, FROM, from end subsystem. Okay, and why we use this hardware? Because its characteristic is speed. Okay, its characteristic is speed. So because of its high speed only, we use this specialized hardware for the image sensors, that is finally for the image. And then we have the computer. So what is a computer? Computer we all know now. So computers also, we have a wide range of computers, starting from our PC which we are using or which we use, and to the supercomputers. Yes, so PCs are the general personal computers and supercomputers. So supercomputer is more progressive or computer? Supercomputer, right? Why? Because supercomputers, it gives particularly high level of performance when you compare to your general purpose computer. Okay, then we go on to software. So what is a software? So software means it's already embedded in your computer systems, right? So here we are talking about image processing software. Okay, so in image processing, the software, it consists of some specialized modules, and those specialized modules are used to perform some specific task. Okay, so did you get that? So software In image processing, it consists of some specialized modules, and that specialized modules will also perform some specific tasks. Okay, so here also software, it comes with two types. One is a very well designed package and one is some sophisticated package. Okay, so in well designed package, what it includes is it allows users like us to they get the opportunity to write codes, okay, using that well designed package. That is, it comes with some capability of allowing the user to write codes, okay, and that code, whichever you will write or we will write, it will be used by that specialized module which is present in the software. Okay, that is one type. And one is sophisticated package. Sophisticated package means it comes with some general purpose commands, and those general purpose commands will be getting it from some special C programming language, or say programming language, that is C, C++, Java. Okay, so software, image processing software comes with two packages. One is well-designed package and the other is sophisticated software package. So well-designed package allows us or users like us to write codes, and sophisticated packages already comes with some software commands which it gets it from some programming language. So did you get the two types of image processing software now? Yes? Any confusion in any of these points? Yes? No? Kundu kam? Image processing software? Acha, duta type? Acha. Image processing software mane, it is software, we already know, software, it is something which is embedded in the system only, right? But in image processing software, we talk about some specialized packages. That will only be used for those images only. Okay, so that software, it comes with two packages. One is a very well-designed package and the other is some sophisticated package. So in well-designed package, what happens is it gives the user the ability to produce our own codes. Okay, we can write our own codes in any language. Say, suppose we are talking about MATLAB here. So we can write our code in MATLAB, and that MATLAB code will be used by the specialized modules which are present in the software. Okay, so we already said that software in image processing, it comes with some specialized modules, and that specialized module will perform some specialized task. Okay, so after you have written the code, that MATLAB code will be used by the specialized modules which are already there in the software, that is image processing software. And the second one is the sophisticated package. Sophisticated package means it will consist of some software commands, that is general purpose software commands, and those commands you'll be getting it from some coding. Say I'm talking about MATLAB code. Okay, so in one you will get to write the code, and the other you will already the commands will be there which is present in the suppose MATLAB code. So that is a bit sophisticated, that's why its name is sophisticated. So well-designed package means it is already allowing the user to write its own code. A sophisticated package means the coding, like part of the coding is already there. You'll get the help from the help section in the, say suppose MATLAB. In MATLAB section, if you go to the help section, you'll get the coding, some part of coding and commands and all in there itself. It is already present. By default, it's already there. Okay, so these are the two types of packages. One is well-designed package, the other is sophisticated package. So did you get it now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Then comes mass storage. So what is storage? So why do we need a storage in a computer, say? Why do we need a storage?
To store something.
Yes, to store the data or to store something, right? So here also mass storage means when we capture the image or when we perform some operations on the image, we'll need some storage, and suppose we will need some storage space to store those images or whatever you have processed or whatever image you have processed, you will need some storage. So that is the mass storage. Okay, so mass storage means, suppose it is a very important part in image processing software. Okay, why? Because whatever you are processing for the image or whatever image is being processed, it has to be stored in the mass storage. Suppose storage also, we have three types. Okay, we have three types. One is short-term storage, one is online storage, and one is archival storage. So short-term storage, the name already says it. Short-term means what? It comes for a short period. That is, you can use that storage only for a short period of time. Afterwards, it's deleted. That is, it's of no use. In online storage means, you can store it in the form of some online storage. That is, in storage, it will come in online form. That also, a different topic is there. So that is solely online. Okay, so short term and archival is offline, and online is a different term. And in archival storage, we don't actually use the archival storage. We use online and short term only. So archival storage, it is characterized by some infrequent access. That is, archival means like a short term storage means you'll use it at that moment, and after that it won't be used. That is, it won't be saved. But archival means you can frequently or infrequently you can use that storage. That is archival storage. So there are three types of storage. One is short-term storage, one is online storage, and the other is archival storage. Okay, then comes image displays. So what is display? So in general or in layman term, what is a display? Suppose you are watching a TV. So when we say a TV display, what do you understand by TV display?
Monitor
and
a screen.
Yes, monitor. Not generally speaking, it's a monitor. Yes, and monitors, you know, monitor means what? Some images, some graphic display cards, and these are some integral part of the computer system. So no monitor means no computer. Okay, so image displays. So suppose, take an example of, I'm talking about the TV screen only. So nowadays what happens, we get a lot of displays, LCD, LED and all those, right? So we have so many displays nowadays, and those are all colored. Previously we used to have all those black and white color, black and white TV systems and displays, right? So now we are talking about TV monitors, and almost all of them are flat screens only. Okay, so these displays that we are talking about nowadays, these are flat screen TV monitors, and these monitors are driven by some outputs of the image only, right? So whatever you say, these are all motion images, right? So these are all motion images, and graphic display cards, which are the integral part of a computer system. So these are image display means what we are talking about. We are just giving an example. Say I'm talking about TV displays, or say computer display, or your mobile screen display. So those are image displays. What it is trying to focus in is that finally it is an image only, right? Maybe it is a still image or a motion in image in motion. So we have only two types. Yes, one is still and one is in motion. And then we talk about hard copy. So what is a hard copy? Soft copy, hard copy, you already know, right? Soft copy means which it's in the form of some, whichever you are placing it in your systems, but whichever you can access it from the system. Hard copy means what? You can touch. That is, suppose hard copy means what? Suppose you are taking a printout of the copy, that is a hard copy, right? Yes. So simple. So they are talking. Yeah. So they are talking about those hard copy devices here. Okay. So, and finally, they are talking about network. So what they are trying to say is, whatever you can see here, everything or almost all of the things, they'll be working only if you have a network. Okay. So network means what? We are talking about our internet connection. So if you have the internet connection only, some of these will work. say I was talking about online mass storage, right? So online mass storage will only work when you have a network. Okay, so we have seven types. So these seven types are the most basic elements of digital image processing. Okay, so did you get it now? Elements? Did you get it? Elements? Elements of digital? Yes. Okay. Okay. So then we will go on to relationship of pixels. Okay, your next topic is relationship of pixels. I won't go in depth today. I'll just give you the some basic concepts of a neighbor of a pixel. Okay, or say types of relationships of a pixel. So when I'm talking about a pixel, so what is a pixel?
Smallest unit of a pixel.
Smallest unit of a pixel, right? Okay, and why do we use a pixel in case of image? Why do we use a pixel
for resolution?
Okay, for resolution. And
for the scaling.
Okay, scaling.
Scaling measurements.
Scaling, measurements, resolution. Okay, and any other features?
To represent something virtual.
To represent something virtual. Okay, and see, we have a lot of features of a pixel in an image. Okay, pixel, it may be the smallest unit of the image, but it is the most, you can say, the foremost important part of the image. Okay, and here we are talking about neighbors of a pixel. Okay, so basically when we are talking about relationship between pixels, definitely there has to be relationship from one pixel to the other, right? Because an image is constituted of pixels only, right? So for that pixel, for those pixels also, there is relationship between the pixels, and there are five main relationships. Okay, so one is a neighborhood, one is adjacency, one is connectivity, one is a path, and the other is regions and boundaries. Okay, I'll come up with these topics in the next session. So today I'll just give you some concepts. So here, suppose we are talking about neighbor of a pixel. So what do you see in this image? Yes, what do you see in this image? Some lines. Okay, you know now. Okay, so you have x and y axis. So one is inverted, right? So in pixel, in neighbors, what we are trying to say is, in any pixel, when you are talking about any pixel in an image, say I'm taking it as P, the pixel, I'm representing it as P, and the coordinate is x comma y. Okay, so PXY, I'm telling, okay, P of XY, it has two vertical, and two horizontal neighbors. Okay, and these are also specified by some set of equations. Okay, those equations will come. Okay, then we have again these set of pixels. These are also, we have two types. One is say four neighbors of P, that is pixels, and one is eight neighbors of P. Okay, so in four neighbors of P, what happens? Okay, I'll go to this thing. So these are all, say there, it is denoting by f of xy. Suppose I'm denoting as f of xy. So these are all neighborhood, or say neighbors of a pixel. Okay, and it is in the form of x and y. See, two coordinates, we have two coordinates, that is f of xy. See, f of x1, x, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, and so on. Okay, then here what it is saying, a pixel P at coordinates xy, it has four horizontal and four vertical neighbors. Okay, it has four horizontal and four vertical neighbors. Suppose you can consider this area. Okay, and then their coordinates, again it is given by these. Say for f of 2 1, that is for this coordinate, the function is x plus 1 of y. Okay, we won't go in depth today, it will be very difficult. I'll have to explain it step by step. Okay, this is just for reference today. So then, acha, we'll talk about some concepts only. So what is adjacency in layman terms? What do you understand by adjacent? Yes, what is parallel, what is adjacent, what do you understand by those adjectives?
And parallels mean data similar.
Okay, so you can use any language. Okay, Assamese, but use Assamese Hindi or English only. Okay, not more than that. So you can use any language, you can explain it in any language, but just explain. Okay, if you know, you can explain. So you are, so Arindam is saying parallel means similar.
Similar, it is same thing together. Similar below. Or adjacent means reverse type. Duita thilo lo reverse type hobo pare.
Reverse type. Mane opposite hobo pare.
Opposite hobo pare.
Okay, thik ache. So adjacent parallel mane similar, adjacent mane opposite. Okay, fine. So you have the idea now. So what he's talking here is, when we are talking about two pixels, okay, two pixels, they are adjacent if they are neighbors, if they are neighbors. Okay, so two pixels are adjacent if they are neighbors, and then in the intensity level is satisfying some specific criteria of similarity. See, so they are talking that two pictures are adjacent if they are neighbors. When they are neighbors also, they have some similarity also, but they are adjacent also. That is, they are opposite to each other, but they are neighbors. Okay, and these intensity. Okay, what is intensity? Intensity means we are talking about brightness. That is lighter or darker. That is, we are talking about the brightness of an image here. Okay, so here they have to, the adjacency concept between the two pixels, they have to consider some intensity level, and if they accept, that is, if they fall within that intensity level only, then the two pixels are said to be adjacent to each other. That is diagonally opposite. Okay, adjacent. Adjacent means, see, these two are adjacent. F of 0, 0 and f 1, 1. These two are adjacent. These two are adjacent. So adjacent means opposite. Parallel means these two, these two. Okay, then example they are giving, suppose for binary image. So for binary image, we already know intensity value, we have only two pixels, 0 and 1. But in gray level image or grayscale image, we have values from 0 up to 255. But as already said, those 256 values, those will be in the range of black and white only. Okay, so see, we have 256 different varieties of black and white also. Okay, then in binary image, two pixels are adjacent if they are neighbors and have some intensity value either 0 or 1. Okay, so when we are talking about binary images, in binary images, if we talk about two pixels, and if two pixels, if we want them to be adjacent, that is diagonally similar, then they have to be neighbors, and definitely they have to have the intensity value of either 0 or 1. And if they qualify these characteristics, if they qualify these properties, then it is known as that those two pixels are adjacent for a binary image. And same thing happens for grayscale image. If the image contains more gray value levels in range from 0 to 255, and if those two pixels, again we talk about those two pixels only, if those pixels are adjacent to each other, then means it is qualifying for the adjacency concept. Okay, so did you get something? Did you get the concept of adjacency? See, first when you use the terms, suppose I'm talking adjacent, similarity, suppose neighbors, you already know these concepts. In first, whenever you get these terms in exam or lab or wherever, always first think about the layman language, the layman concept. Okay, so adjacent, which we know, similarly opposite, that is oppositely similar, sorry. And parallel means that is also similar, but they are facing to each other. Okay, they are facing front to front. Adjacent means diagonally opposite. So see, in layman language, always think first in layman language and then use the technical terms. So here we are talking about adjacency in an image. So image means what? Definitely we will talk about pixels, and pixel means what we are talking about. It is the foremost part in an image. Yes, so try to connect the dots in that way. Okay, so see, each and every concept is very important. That is why I'm going step by step. Okay, so at any point if you have any doubt, just ask. Okay, otherwise in future it will be a bit problem for you people to understand. Okay, and if you want some classes also to repeat, I'll repeat also those classes, but just clarify your doubt every time. Okay, then we spoke about adjacency. Adjacency also we have types: 4 adjacency, 8 adjacency, M adjacency. So today we won't talk on all those, it's a bit complicated. So just try to learn that we have 5 basic relationships of a pixel. One is the neighborhood. You know, you have a neighborhood. So then adjacency, that is diagonally opposite. Then connectivity also, it's a property, that is, it's a relationship property, that is how well it will connect, that is the pixels, how well it will connect. Then paths. So paths come after adjacency and connectivity, that is it will show some paths, that is direction. Okay, and if it fulfills that, then only it can go to the regions and boundaries, which is the 5th basic relationship between pixels. Okay, so today we'll stop here, and do we have a class tomorrow? I think
Yes, ma'am. Tomorrow morning.
Oh, first class.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so tomorrow morning is first class. Tomorrow we won't start with such boring topic. I'll take up some different topic. I'll take this in on Monday. So this is a bit complicated, and when you will start off with the lab session, then you can understand it more well. Okay, so let's see, I may take up this topic, or let's take up some interesting topic tomorrow. Okay, so how many of you are present today? 9, I guess.
Ma'am, exceptionally all are present.
Except Kaushik, all are present today.
No, except Shafiqul.
Oh, except Shafiqul. Acha. Acha.
Still lab logon ne. Lab.
Aaj to lab nahi. Aaj lab asle neki.
No asle.
Aaj lab asle neki. Oh, aaj moy bhabilu Thursday. কাইলৈ বুলি ভাবি আছিলো ওকে আজি ৱেডনেছডে এই আজি টুডে উই ক্যান স্টার্ট অফ উইথ ল্যাব বিকজ উই হ্যাভ নট গন টু দ্য কনসেপ্টস অনলি না ওকে ওকে দেন ওকে দেন টুমরো আই ক্যান ডু ওয়ান থিং উই ক্যান স্টার্ট অফ উইথ ম্যাটল্যাব কনসেপ্টস সো দ্যাট নেক্সট উইক ইউ ক্যান এট লিস্ট লার্ন দ্য প্রোগ্রামস ইফ ইউ ডোন্ট ইভেন হ্যাভ ল্যাপটপস দ্য অনলাইন ম্যাটল্যাব সফটওয়্যার ইট কামস for mobile also. Mobile version also is there. You don't have to download also. Suppose if I give you the programs, you can also run those programs in that online, you know, online as well. Okay, so okay, let's stop it here for today. So except who is absent, you said?
Shafiqul.
Okay, except Shafiqul, all are pretty. Okay, so I just take a screenshot of this. Okay, okay, so we can stop here for today. You can go on with the next class, and see you all tomorrow at 9. Okay,
thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay,
thank you, ma'am.
Okay.